JD's motto has always been, make it better. I think my first encounter with JD was Little League football. We had a powerhouse team at our elementary school, and we played his elementary school, and the only player with any athletic talent was JD.
Jeff and I lost our pole vaulting mentor, Frank, our freshman year in high school, and Jeff lost his mom several weeks later, his freshman year in high school. He's just been persistent in the face of adversity and what I would call the vicissitudes of life.
Because of his athletic talent, he got a pole vaulting scholarship to Brand X down on the Brazos River.
Jeff had a lot of nicknames, but his first nickname was Hilda Transfer because he came from A&M. And he integrated very, very well, very quickly with all the rest of the guys.
Everybody's kind of searching for who they are in their college years. And I think that search was extremely important for Jeff. And obviously things have worked out unbelievably well for him. But I think UT was an important launching pad for the Jeff Hildebrand we all see today.
When he graduated, he went to work for Exxon at Corpus Christi, came back to Texas, got a master's in petroleum engineering. After he graduated, he worked for Hughes, Texas Petroleum. After that, he went to work for American Exploration.
When he came back to Houston to start his own company, American Energy Capital, that's really when I would say he became an independent.
And I can remember when a big deal for Jeff was $5 million. And he would buy properties and, you know, and then he was doing $10 million deals. And then he was doing $20 million deals. And I can remember the first time he told me he did a $100 million deal. And then, you know, before you know it, they were billion-dollar transactions.
Hilcorp Energy is one of the largest private companies in the oil and gas business in the United States.
I think Jeff's very good at fostering a culture which is very much teamwork-oriented. You know, at Hilcorp one year, it was a three-year program. If they reached a certain production level for the entire company, everyone in the company got a new car. And then the next program after that, every employee got $100,000. Those people go above and beyond because he's created some interesting incentive programs for them.
He is really interested in trying to figure out how to make his people well off financially and grow their career and expand what they get to see.
Along the way, he's built up several other companies, probably the most notable of which is Harvest, which is a midstream company. They've kind of under the radar, that's grown into quite a sizable company.
Your kids reflect who you are. And at the end of the day, that's your ultimate legacy.
The fact that they have a very close-knit, grounded family, despite all the success, I think is a real tribute to Jeff and to Mindy. He's always seems to be off attending an event with a child or going hunting with the boys or going to watch one of Brittany's horse shows.
He and Mindy have been involved, you know, from redoing Memorial Park in Houston, Texas, to Star Hope Mission, to family legacy missions, the Zambian mission that I'm heavily involved in.
You get invited to join a lot of these things, but a lot of times you can just, you know, your checkbook can show up and that's it. Jeff doesn't do it that way. He's a meaningful participant.
Probably the biggest one and the oldest one in terms of their family history is the Houston Livestock Show and Rodeo. They've been steadfast at it for, I'm gonna guess, at least 50 years. Basically, Jeff and Mindy get behind something, they're gonna figure out a way to get it funded.
You know, after Jeff got a master's in petroleum engineering, we both joined the advisory board of the petroleum engineering school. From there, we went to the engineering advisory board.
The Hildebrand School of Geosciences, I believe it is, petroleum engineering and geosciences, is near and dear to Jeff's heart. You know, that was his degree plan. He really wanted to give something back to the school, and you know, he was able to give a significant gift.
Jeff was asked to be a board of regents of the University of Texas system. And as part and parcel of being on the board of regents, he became chairman of UTIMCO, and they basically are trying to manage the financial assets that are underneath the University of Texas system.
He was enough of a businessman to be able to chaperone, steward, provide good common sense recommendations as to what they might tweak, what they might do differently.
He also was chairman of the University of Texas lands, which feeds into the PUP fund, Permanent University Fund, which is very important.
And he has continuously and constantly given back to the University of Texas.
We thank you for all that you've contributed. We congratulate you on this distinguished alumni award. And most importantly, always remember, hook 'em horns, brother.